Whenever I hear our educational or business leaders speak about what our students are going to need when they graduate and become 21st century citizens, the list of creative and intellectual qualities they give sounds remarkably like the system of education designed by Maria Montessori nearly 100 years ago.
The materials in the classroom are very versatile. So you might have one set of materials which can be used so many different ways. And even the children discover that according to their personality, according to their skill sets, and according to their developmental levels, they make their own individual discoveries about materials. And actually, the environment is there for them in order to do that. Rather than be told things by somebody who has worked with a material in a certain way, it's much more desirable for them to discover on their own. It makes them interested in learning, makes them interested in becoming scientists themselves, actually.
So the thing that I took away most from Montessori School was how to do problem solving in steps, but not only reaching the end of the problem, but actually understanding the concepts behind the problem.
They have their own plan, they have their own set of goals that they need to accomplish by the end of the day, and they know what's asked of them. It's just been wonderful to see her grow and evolve and absorb everything the Montessori system provides.
And those are kind of super important skills for finding your place in the real world, whatever you choose to be, whether you choose to be a doctor or a dentist or a management consultant or a computer programmer. We don't all exist in isolation in ourselves doing some job. You can only be successful by working with other people in this world, and I really don't see any other form of education that goes after that.
It's just wonderful that they can come in and go right to work. They don't have to be directed or talked to or sat in a desk. And, as we all know, especially young children, want to move. Their whole physicality is so developing that they need to get up and explore their environment and sit down when they're ready, when they're tired, or gather with a couple of friends and have some downtime, and then feel refreshed from that and get up and engage in more of an intellectually stimulating work.
Again, that's strength of knowing what I want and who I am, and how to find the things that I'm looking for, even when I'm not necessarily sure where they would be. That kind of drive and independence really stuck with me from my Montessori education.
What is Montessori? Montessori method is to follow the child. And when you talk about follow the child, that means you observe the child and to fulfill his needs. So you have to start from the observe the child and to see where he is and start from there to facilitate the child.
I like to think of Montessori as having invisible scaffolding, that the teacher actually has the child in a very developed set curriculum and knows where the child is with each piece, and where the child is developmentally, what their skill set is in math, social sciences, etc. And while the child feels like they are freely choosing their work and is moving from the piece that they want to the piece that they want to, the teacher is actually very directive of that.
I was just amazed when they started talking about the Big Bang. I think in traditional education, the Big Bang is something that's taught to 21-year-olds when they do advanced physics, whereas my 4-year-old, when he came here, was talking about, well, there's the Big Bang out here, and then we come into the kind of the universe and the galaxy and our solar system and the planets and Earth and me and the insect. Just that kind of contraction of place in the universe, I thought, was just very, very inspiring.
My goal is to engage the kids again in their own education, but it's also a time of great upheaval in their lives. They're making a transition from being in a safe, secure environment to walking into the world. And championing that is incredibly important. They're going through an experience that's largely social. In some ways, I think the social experience maybe primary and middle school. I don't want to negate the academics, but they're trying to figure out where they are in the world. And the academics, to them, are secondary to that. Maybe our job is to make the connections.
I've definitely felt that my Montessori education has set me up for success. I graduated as the valedictorian of my class this year, and I've just, it really fostered my appreciation and love of learning.